Here's a video to explain fraction comparison using the method I taught you in the morning. So let's say we have a number 5 by 6 and we want to compare it with 6 by 7 and we want to know which one is bigger. Now these are called denominators. Right, and I'm sure you remember the top ones are called numerators. So what we are going to do is we are going to multiply the two denominators. So step one will be we multiply 6 times 7, which will give us 42. Then step 2 is we multiply the numerator also with the same number that you multiplied the denominator with. So we had multiplied 6 with 7. So we'll also multiply 5 with 7. So step 2 is 5 times 7 is 35, and we had multiplied 7 with 6, so we'll also multiply 6 with 6. That will give you 6 times 6 is 36. So now let's write our fraction down. We know that both have the denominator 42. So this is our step 3. I'll put the denominators. How does it help us to do this? It helps us by making the denominator same. So we know whatever it is, it's a cake or a chocolate or whatever it is, it's cut into 42 pieces. Whatever the object is, it is cut into 42 pieces. Once we know that it's cut into the same number of pieces, the numbers become easy to compare. So we had done 5 times 7 is 35. And we had done 6 times 6 is 36. So whichever object it has been cut into 42 pieces. So I'm asking you, 35 by 42 is bigger or 36 by 42 is bigger? So now it's simpler for you to solve and you can tell me 36 by 42 is a bigger fraction. Okay. This is the method we learned where we make the denominators the same, in case the denominators of the fractions are not the same. And if I had to compare something like 2 by 4 by 3 by 4, it's so much simpler because I know the object or whatever the thing is, cake, has been cut into 4 pieces in both the fractions. And I'm wondering if 2 by 4 is a bigger fraction or is 3 by 4 a bigger fraction. And it's obvious to me that 3 by 4 is a bigger fraction. If I am getting 2/4 of the cake, which is also equal to half the cake, versus me getting 3/4 of the cake, it means that 3/4 is more. So if I get this fraction, I'll be happier. To make our problem, this problem, as easy as this, we go through these steps.